What's up, y'all? I am Marcus, also known as ENB. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to From the Dark. It is the final month of From the Dark. It's December 1st, 2015, and I am going to endeavor to finish the series entirely by the end of this month. And I haven't actually talked about this much yet, but I kind of see this playthrough, this From the Dark playthrough, as being my, more or less my channel send-off for Dark Souls 1. Not to say that I might not do some casual play here or there in the future, because it's just a damn fun game. Ooh, baby, a triple! It's just a fun game, and I'm sure I'll continue to play it some in the future, but as far as long-form content like this, you're looking at it. I think this is probably the last major Dark Souls series. Like, bittersweet, isn't it? It's been a great run. Like, this game has provided so many countless hours of entertainment. But yeah, I think this is gonna be the last, like, major run. Today, our old hunter is spicing things up a little bit with some great arrows. Great bow. See if we can get a good shot on this guy. This guy! Ooh, a little too high. Cause little high, little low. Bam! Oh, my arrow. Fuck, got the headshot, baby. Alright, here we go. Let's get this one too. Do. See ya. Ooh. Oh, yeah. Fucking. I almost said ducks in a barrel. Fucking copying Grubby, I guess, from. What was it? Was it Dreamhack where he said that shit? It's funny. It's like shooting ducks in a barrel. There we go. I don't know what to do, man. So this is what it's like to be a Silver Knight Archer. this section is actually kind of a pain in the ass if you just approach it without using any sort of ranged attacks at all. You can see a little ambush over there to the right. There's another one over here to the left. And then there was one melee mob and then two casters. And it's just, I think this is a double pull. Yeah, these guys come together. Another one of those kind of scripted ambushes. Bam. Ooh. Got that off balance hit on one of them for 670. Six motherfucking 70. Our shadow on the tar-like surface of, I guess, the abyss. Forgot this was here. I'm glad I explored. Soul of a brave warrior. There are a few soul items that I just tend to forget in the game. Including that one. Once again, we've got these headless statues. And if we look up and back this way, see where we came from. It's amazing, like, the sense of scale that these games always manage to give you with the different, like, vistas and perspectives and whatnot. That's really part of the, like, genius of the game and its level design is just, it's the intangibles, you know what I'm saying? This guy's a total jerk. If you use light attacks on him, he has a deflection type similar to Iron Flesh or a Great Shield or what have you that will cause your attacks to rebound, similar to the Armored Boars, but and ooh, I missed. Hey, no, what's going on? There we go. But if you use two-handed R2s, You won't. Let me see if I can show you a deflection here. Well, actually, I guess the Zweihänder, I don't know if it's because I killed him or because the Zweihänder is just badass, I don't know. But a lot of weapons will deflect off of him and as if you hit a wall. Chain armor, leather gauntlets, chain leggings. They added this in the DLC. This enemy can actually drop the chain set for you, whereas other than that, the undead merchant's the only source of it, purchasing it. So if you kill the undead merchant and the undead burg, like that. That's what I'm talking about, bouncing off. If you kill that merchant, then you wouldn't be able to get it until New Game Plus. Except, of course, now that the DLC's out. Can do it. Totally get it. All these headless statues. I seriously wonder. It looks to me as if the head was taken off. Right? Right. That's just how it appears to me. I don't know. It would be fascinating to know the truth 100% on that and what it symbolizes. And one more nasty little surprise for you. And with this, we enter this, what appears to be a prison area, covered and tainted with the abyss. This is the point the abyss is spreading from. What appears to be Ulasil's prison. And you have to wonder how many of the bloatheads that you encounter throughout the stage, how many of them are escaped from the prison. I don't know. The abyss seems to have driven them mad. I wonder if it was a prison break that led to the discovery of the abyss in Ulasil. They said a toothy serpent, or both Elizabeth and, Elizabeth, I can't remember if Elizabeth says anything about it. Both Chester and Goff mention that the people of Ulasil were deceived by a serpent. And that they awoke that thing themselves. See some treasure from here. Something interesting flickering in the distance there. Chasmo Libus. Oh yeah, you! Get wrecked. Crystal Lizard I almost forgot about. Here we can hop down and take that guy out. But there's treasure for everybody, mostly for me, right over here. How the fuck? Oh man. Oh shit. No. Ooh. Recovered just in the nick of time. See if I can pull this one. Pull. Doing a little bit more than just pulling these guys, though. Half fucking killing them. Sucker. He thought he had me. I can't remember if this is a triple pull. There's a sorcerer mixed in, and the sorcerer is the asshole. Oh, it's not even a double. Oh shit. Still can't parry that. I knew exactly what move he was gonna use. I was ready for it. I just cannot get the timing on that move. People have told me that it is parryable, but it's just got the fucking most funky, strange, weird timing. I don't think I've ever successfully parried it. As a matter of fact, I'm pretty certain I've never successfully parried that attack. And that's really annoying, because I like parrying, man. Come on. God damn it. Would you do it again for me? Oh, well, to hell with it. Man. That move could go to hell. Oh, great, we got the bloated head. I was... That's a drop that we need. That we so desperately need. Oh, I one-shot him. That'll do. That'll do, pig. That was the sorcerer. We got the bloated head. The head of an Ulasil resident whose humanity went wild after being devoured by the Dark of Manus, Father of the Abyss. The bloated head is fissured, the cracks lined with innumerable tiny red eyeballs, with a hard outside and mucus filled inside. No sane person would ever wear this. So the head of an Ulasil resident whose humanity went wild after being devoured by the Dark of Manus, Father of the Abyss. So... I want to say that the thing that was devoured was the resident. Like, the resident was devoured by the dark, and then their humanity went wild, right? Because the way that it's phrased, it could either be the resident who was devoured or the humanity was devoured by the dark. But I want to say that the resident was devoured by the dark. It also kind of indicates that even the people of Ulasil, and I pointed out Dusk's pointy ears, and Elizabeth, like, specifically says that we are... quite human indeed, right? Like, she points out that there's a difference between us and the people of this time. But even within the residents of Ulasil, there's already humanity. There's already fragments of humanity. So you can look at them as being our ancestors or what have you, I guess, is one possible way to interpret that. But they already had humanity, and their humanity indeed went wild after they were devoured by the dark. Manus, Father of the Abyss. And we also get Darkbead. Darkbead doesn't, unfortunately, have much lore for us on it, if I recall correctly. Nothing that we haven't already seen. Abyss sorcery discovered by an Ulasil sorcery on the brink of madness. In contrast to standard soul sorceries, abyss are weighty. Perhaps a human soul is closer to matter in its humanity. We already saw that with Dark Orb. It's slightly different, because this says perhaps human souls, because of their humanity, produce sorceries with more tangible presence. Whereas this one is perhaps a human soul is closer to matter in its humanity. So the dark soul is closer to something physical, closer to something tangible. Perhaps it's closer to matter and farther from energy. It's less like fire and more like something hard and physical. Look at this cute little fella. Ain't they cute? Alright. Goodbye. You've got mail. My wife loves that movie. I don't know why. I can't. Every time I see a Tom Hanks movie, I always... His role in Forrest Gump was just so... That was such a strong character that I can't see him as anything but Forrest Gump. Anyway, that's completely unrelated to Dark Souls. This, however... That's just fucking cool right there. These humanity-like enemies. I guess this is the humanity that went wild. But it's a very striking... Also, something very... interesting on this left side. I didn't find this the first time that I came through. I stumbled upon this from the backside, but this is really cool. And just that fog prevented us from taking any fall damage from that. The illusory wall or illusory floor disappeared. who's responsible for this. Looks a lot like Alvina. Alvina of Darkroot Garden. Where are you going, Alvina? You are. Alvina leads you here to this wall. And I'll say this, these enemies, if you're gonna fight them in melee, large weapons are the way to go. Absolutely the way to go. Because when you touch them, you take damage like I just did. And short weapons, even if you hit them, you can still end up taking damage from it. Like that. But they also are an incredible source of humanity, so it's really good. What was Alvina trying to show us? I'm trying to look at other visual hints as to this. It kind of does look like a pathway leads here. Alvina, what did you want us to see? Ooh, a bunch of humanity surrounding something. Something glowing gold over there. These look like little children, the humanity sprites of small kids. Like children's humanity went wild as well. And we see over there an old friend. An old friend surrounded and in need of help. An old friend who we've already actually killed in our timeline. The Great Grey Wolf Sif. Notice that when the humanity makes contact with this glowing emblem, it kind of is repelled. It can't pass this. It's like a barrier. Sif holding a great sword of Artorias. His mouth, much smaller Sif than what we're used to seeing. The Cleansing Great Shield. The steel great shield used by Knight Artorias, who succumbed to the Abyss. Artorias, deeply scarred by the Abyss, used this to form a barrier to protect his compatriot Sif. Although this drained the shield, its magic defense remains high. A destroyed, deformed, tainted version of Artorias' shield. The Great Shield of Artorias. He could not stop humanity with this shield. He could not protect himself. All he could do was protect Sif. He used it to create a barrier to keep Sif alive. And Alvina is the one who led us to this point. There used to be a rumor long ago when the game first came out. People used to, well, there's a hidden dialogue that Alvina wants you to kill Sif. Like, nope. Exactly the opposite. Alvina is not an enemy of Sif. Alvina is a friend to the Knight Artorias and Sif the Great Grey Wolf. And this pops us out here, back in the Royal Wood. So we've now unlocked a very useful shortcut. Artorias, just an all-around badass. even in defeat. He sacrificed himself rather than let his comrade die. Alright, there is quite a bit of exploration to do still here in the Abyss, though. We'll just come up here and take care of you so that you can't ambush us. Oh, God. Oh, no! Ooh, almost. Now, damn, log on. You die. Ooh. These enemies are pretty irritating. Just because, well, they have a tangible presence and yet they don't. Like, it's a very odd situation. One of these prism stones guiding us. Definitely want to handle this guy. Find a humanity right here. If you skip killing this enemy and just continue on your merry way, he's going to start bombarding you with magic while you're exploring around. And it's really sucky. It's really annoying. I wonder if they have hit. I missed them. There we go. 304. 304. I think it's always 304. I guess they don't have a weak point for the purposes of headshots and what have you. Line it up anyway. Yeah, 304. This bow, the great bows, have got a lot of range. So you can just snipe these guys and see how Hawkeye Golf hunts humanity. I mean, he hunts dragons, but another interesting point about these twin humanity, or these humanities and twin humanities that we're picking up all over the place, these tend to be like nearly full heal items. So in addition to Estus flasks at this point, you have plenty of additional heals available to you. Oh no, no, no. Shit. More humanities. And the black flame. Just a standard corpse. I was curious about that. The black flame is another interesting one in the fact that it's a pyromancy, a dark pyromancy, a pyromancy discovered from the dark of the abyss by a pyromancer who wandered into Ulasil. Conjure a great black flame in one's palm. Black flames are weighty and inflict physical damage enough to smack away the mightiest of shields. Now, from a gameplay perspective, obviously, they just wanted to include a new pyromancy in the DLC, but if you wanted to look at it from a lore perspective, it kind of reinforces the similarities, I guess, between sorceries and pyromancies. Pyromancy actually being developed from the original fire sorceries, if you want to look at it that way. So there's a dark version of sorcery, but there's also, there can be a dark version of pyromancy. Oddly enough, we do not find a dark version of miracles. What up, fam? All right. Okay. It can tear you up really, really quickly if you get a couple of them hitting you at the same time. A situation best avoided. Oh shit. Ooh, baby, a quadruple. I had to check. I almost thought it was a quintuple for a second there. Would have been sweet. We're killing all these guys on our first time through here while we're exploring, but honestly, normally there's not a whole lot of reason to bother with it because, yeah, you can just run by all of these dudes. They're pretty slow. On the other hand, they do drop humanity. Help me carving. This head says, help me. Look again. Can you hear the desperate plea?
Help me.
Oh, man. Fascinating to me, too, that we have humanity. Like, people of Ulasil have humanity that hasn't run wild until they were devoured by, or until their humanity was devoured by Manus of the Abyss. That's actually what prompted it to run wild. Humanity in and of itself wasn't actually causing any problems. Here's the bridge to go across and an item below it. I think I picked up all the items over here. I may have missed one or two little things. I don't think I missed anything with lore importance, lore significance, maybe the soul item or something. Also fascinating, too, that this is a very dark area, but you don't really need light for it. You can kind of see just fine. Although, now that I think about it, I do have a light on me. So you guys can see a little bit better, but it's really not that dark. Now, I realize sometimes on YouTube it looks a little bit darker than what it actually is, but another point, that's a twin humanity's corpse right there that I think that is, once again, yep, that's another male corpse right there, so. So that's two in the DLC that had twin humanities that were masculine corpses. This is the way forward, the way ahead. This leads you into a close encounter of the humanity kind. But it also leads you to treasure. If you're really swift, though, you can actually just hop down right here behind. This is white titanite slab behind that, those humanities in that tunnel. This is the tunnel we were just in. Of course, we were on the other side. Hey, little buddy. And this is the correct, or quote-unquote correct way down, like, the path forward. And we're almost done. Oh, man. Oh, shit, no! Whew. Could have easily killed me. Oh man, the tracking on the Tvi's. R2 is eesh. Not so great for that. They just kind of wander around like oop-a-doop-a-doo. Dodged all your bullshit. Soul of a hero. Now, let's see. We have gotten so many humanities at this point. Just equip them and use them to heal if we need to. Go ahead. Shazam. You You guys know what's coming. And he gets my heart pumping every time. It's been a long while since I fought this guy, so we'll see how it goes. Oh shit. Woo. Hmm. Going decently well. Whew. There's something that shimmers and glimmers. Where is it? Where are you, bro? Do I need to reload? Oh, there it is over there. Range on it. Where the hell is it? Do I need to actually reload the area first? Whew. May need to reload the area. Because I don't see it. Thought I saw something over here, but... Oh shit. No, I don't see it. Alright then. Here, let's reload. Actually, it's worth reloading in any case, because now you can actually see. Yeah, now I can see it. It's down there. But you can also see Manus down there. And yep, you absolutely can. Unbelievably. Cheese him from up here. I don't know what the angle is. Maybe it's from over here. I don't know. I've seen somebody do it before. Might be actually up here? I don't know. Like, it's clear that they tried to put him in there at such an angle that you couldn't hit him from outside the fog, but there is actually a way to do it. Unless they patched it, which I don't think that they did. Either way, I don't really need to, so... Manus is like, every single time, bruh. Every single time, anytime you want to go, bruh. Come on, bruh. And if I recall correctly, many people have told me through the years that Manus is, I think it was Latin for hand, which, given how fucked up his hand is, makes sense. And also makes sense things like manuscript, like written, you know? So, yeah. Manus. Manus as human, or Manus as hand. Either way makes sense. Tagged ya. Where is my buddy? is my buddy at? Man, the range on that is there we go. Summon sign for Sith. Fucking coolest shit ever. Oh shit. If you don't have good, ooh shit, stamina or in good stability, blocking Manus is not really an option, and you need to dodge everything, which fortunately his attacks aren't too rough to dodge, most of them. It's been a long time since I've fought against him, so aw, missed. Shit, glad I rolled that. And remember to let your shield down between blocking, even if you decide to use that strategy. But he gets really nasty right around now. The Funk's old brother. Check it out now. Or maybe it's around half. I can't remember if it's a quarter or half. Oh. Whenever he roars like that, he's gonna do his big shit. Aw, I rolled too early. Or too late. One or the other. Probably too early. I know I rolled too early that time. Cool, bro. Got Estus. It looks like a grab, but I believe you can actually block it. Oh shit, I rolled too late. Oh, I thought I was gonna be smooth with that. Where is that Sif summon? I wanna stay near it. Cause I do wanna summon Sif, but I don't wanna do it too early. It's about time to do it, eh? Oh shit, that was slow. Oops, 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 oops! I fucked up the dodge. And then healed too soon. Ooh, I fucked that all up. We got tons of humanity I can heal all day, they. As long as I don't do nothing too stupid. Like that. I'll heal right in your face! And then you'll hit me as a result. Okay, Kyoku, I got hit. Oh shit. Close to Manus and. Believe if you get close enough to Manus, that will not hit you. I'm gonna assume that I just did not get close enough. Using your own humanity against you. No, 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 no. The silver pendant can deflect all this stuff, but, as you might have guessed, ah, shit. Where is my Sif, bro? Oh, God. Gotta roll to the side of that one. Like I said, it's been forever since I fought Manus. I've forgotten all his tales. Oh, shit. Where is... There you are, buddy. Here we go. Help is on the way. Should be magic time. Hit him, Sif. Oh no, he hit Sif. Alright. I rolled too late. I was trying to use iframes to dodge it. I gotta remember how to dodge that attack. I mean, I guess I don't really have to remember, but... No, don't you dare! I missed. As you saw. Oh shit, no, I died! Aw, man. Aw, man! Okay. So, back to Ulusil Township. And we can use the shortcut to get back there. Too much fucking around with Manus. And he got me. But at this point in the game, we now have access to not only an infinite, but also a very easy to access supply of humanity. Those guys drop it like crazy, because you saw how many we got. We weren't even using the gold serpent ring, so that from this point on is no longer a concern for us at all. So we can revive whenever we want, we can kindle whenever we want, you know, all those great things. We can just heal using humanity at any time. It's no big deal at this point. And this is kind of where, like, the endurance aspect of, not the stat endurance, but like the marathon boss fights where you run out of Estus and the reason you can't win or whatever is because you're out of Estus. That's where that kind of disappears at this point, because you essentially have infinite healing items. Well, not infinite, but you've got 99, you can have 99 humanities, 99 twin humanities, and 20 Estus flasks, not to mention whatever divine blessings that you happen to have. So, yeah. Changes things up quite a bit. Let's see if I can remember the dodge timings for Manus properly. They're coming. Yeah, they're coming. Whoa! Hey, that's convenient. Well, I guess he got me with his toes when he jumped. Ah, I missed. Crap. I ain't doing too good, guys. So don't have to tell you. Oh shit, that's dead. Ooh, I thought he was gonna get me before I actually healed at all. God damn it. It sucks when you're too close to him when he does that jump, because it has a hitbox on his feet that appears very quickly. Alright, there we go. Aw, I was a little bit slow. I was waiting to see if he was going to do his staff follow-up. Wish you could cut his tail. Oh shit. That feeling when you know you got greedy and you know you fucked up. It's too late to do anything about it though. Always felt like that move hit farther than it actually does. Whack your arm, dude. Where is my Sif summon anyway? I do want to have him around when we finish the fight if I can. Just because. are you, Sif, bro? Oh, there you are, over there. Cool. Cool story, Manus. Cool story, man. Oh shit. Whew. The tail turn around, that's kind of a rare one. Don't really see that too often. Or at least I don't. It may depend on how you fight him, I guess. Oh shit. No, I didn't have enough stamina because I was too slow to swap my Damn, I dodged too early too. Manus is just generally kicking my ass. He is straight up tougher than Artorias for me, but I mean, it makes sense for him to be stronger than Artorias from a story perspective at the very least. Where did my Sif bro go? Because he's about to start using dark magic now. I guess I should equip, I could have equipped the silver pendant, but I always tended to have better luck dodging this stuff without it, but smack. Oh shit. I was too slow. Ha! Nice! Sif with the jump attack. Look at me. Look at me do. Boo-ba-ba-doo. Oh shit. I couldn't see where he was going. Oh shit, this could be a death. Whew. I knew I was right at the edge. Sucker. I remembered that attack. Sif, get his attention, man. Oh shit. Oh shit, no, 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 no. That attack. Not as much as the one where it comes crashing in as a circle. That's the one that normally gets me. And he kicked me with his feet. It's okay, I kicked him with my Zweihänder. Oh, I thought I had him. Get you this time. And Sif will survive. High five, puppy bro. I think you normally get 10 humanity from defeating him. I can't remember if you summon Sif and Sif dies if you don't get to 10 humanity. I seem to remember something like that. Oh, man. I know people are going to complain about what a poor fight I put up. Just go watch the damn Calamitous Intent challenge if you want to see me tear him a new one. It's been a while, guys. Been a while since I heard that shitty stained song. and we're just gonna leave her here because that's just how Dark Souls handles things. Oh man.
Awaited thee. Thou hast rescued Princess Dusk and rid us of that terrible primeval human, even halting the spread of the Abyss. I salute the grandeur of thine enterprise. Please allow me to express my gratitude. I thank thee, as do we all. I will remember thee, but I will keep thy story to myself. This is the best way, for thou art come from a time far ahead. No one will sing thy praises, but yet thy greatness shall live on, for it shall be my purpose to remember all thou hast done for us.
We shall be remembered. Our legend shall live on as the legend of Artorias. Fucking wonderful.
May the flames guide thee.
One more thing that we need to do to wrap up Dusk's quest line. Oh, what's the nearest? I guess Undead Parish.
Dusk of Ulysseo, it is an honor to see thee again. I shall follow thine wishes. This may strike thine ear as somewhat peculiar, but long ago, in my homeland of Ulysseo, I was beset by a creature from the Abyss. I would have perished then, were it not for the great knight Artorias. In truth, I saw little of what transpired, for mine senses were already fled. But even still, there was something about Artorias, a certain balance of the humors that quite perfectly fits your semblance. Heavens, could it be that... Oh, dear me, that was Ulysseo, many centuries ago. Please excuse my fanciful musings.